Hey everyone, in this tutorial we're going to take a look at how to import motions into iClone from a variety of different sources, including online animation libraries, Blender, 3ds Max, Maya, and Mixamo, as well as motion capture. I have a number of motions from different sources prepared here, and we'll look at how we can easily convert them for use with Reallusion characters. It really doesn't matter where you get your motions from, as long as they're made for a biped character, you'll be able to convert and use them in iClone on any original or imported character, thanks to the ability to map and standardize all of the data. Let's start by importing in this FBX motion from 3ds Max. You can simply click and drag the FBX file directly onto your character in iClone to bring up the import settings panel. Since this was a motion generated with a 3ds Max biped character, we want to ensure that we have that selected for our motion profile. The T-pose import is optional, however, in many cases you may experience small little quirks or issues without it, as you can see here. It's recommended to keep the frames per second at 60 in most cases, with Select Bone Root active and the Bone Root selected. If the FBX contains more than a single motion, you can also generate a perform list, but in this case we're only importing in a single motion, so that won't have any difference. The motion will be easily applied to your Reallusion model, and we can play back to preview. Any motions imported will automatically be saved to the external motion folder in the Custom tab of the Content Manager. If you want to set a different thumbnail, simply scrub to the frame you want to capture in the timeline, get a good camera perspective, and right-click on the thumbnail and select Capture to update it. Once you have this motion saved, you can then apply it to any other biped character saved in iClone. Keep in mind that due to proportions and other factors, minor tweaks may be needed later on. Okay, let's move on to the Perform List Editor. You can access this by right-clicking on your character. Our character's current list is looking a bit weak, so let's go ahead and add a couple more motions that were originally created for DAZ G8 characters. You can import multiple animations at the same time, however, please be aware that they need to be from the same source. Once we've added these, you'll see them appear in the Content Manager, and the Perform List will also be updated. You can apply the motion to test it out. You can see that the motion will be retargeted perfectly, and ready for use on any Reallusion biped character. Again, we recommend you find a frame of the animation that gives a better impression of what the motion is all about, then recapture the thumbnail for better future reference. Okay, let's look at a cool scenario where we can blend together motions from different sources with some quick editing in iClone. First, I'm going to again go to the Perform List and add a walking motion sourced from the Blender Meta Rig. Next, a jogging motion sourced from the 3ds Max Biped Rig, again, being sure to add in a source T-pose in each situation for ideal results. Up next is a running motion from Motion Builder. Because some animation sources may have similar skeletal naming conventions, occasionally a similar motion profile will be detected. In this case, the original detection is from Mixamo, so we'll switch that over to the correct one. Finally, I'll import an injured run animation from Mixamo. Once the motions are submitted, you'll again see that the Content Manager has been updated with more motions, and you can right-click to apply these motions from your character's perform menu. With looping enabled, you can click and drag on the end of a clip to loop it like I'm doing here to the walk motion. We can then throw the jogging motion in there and loop it a few times as well. I'll move it a bit forward on the timeline so that it's closer to the looping walk motions, and then apply and loop the running motion, and finally the injured walking motion. To get better blending between the different looped motions, we can click and drag one on top of the other, which will create a transition area which automatically blends one motion with the other. It's important here to be aware of which foot is planted, along with the length of the transition area. No two motions will blend together the same way, and it takes a bit of trial and error to find the right position and timing for the best results. The clip blending feature in iClone allows you to flawlessly connect motions coming from four different sources so it looks like a single continuous movement. iClone also supports a number of motion capture profiles as well, including Deep Motion, Radical, Move.ai, PixCap, Plask, and Rococo Video. you can import these in both FBX and BVH formats. You can see when I drag in this mocap motion from Deep Motion that iClone will automatically detect the correct profile. Simply import the T-pose again, follow the procedure, and test out the results by playing back. Raw mocap animations may still need to be tweaked and adjusted for accuracy. Luckily, iClone contains a number of motion tools that you can use to clean up your raw data. You can see how motion correction can fix foot sliding here. There are a number of other tools including motion direction control, motion modifier, and much more. Please check out our dedicated tutorials for all of these features to get step-by-step details on how you can use them to quickly and easily improve and customize your animations. That's it for this video, guys. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.